Hi, my name is Thomas Kim. This session of video continues from my previous video 4. Now this is video 5. If you haven't watched my previous video, please watch my previous video 4 about implement rational number with template method programming. We will learn how to get common type. When we are given type 1, type 2, how can you get common type of T1 and T2? So, if we are given two templates, for example, template type name, T1 and type name T2. If we are given two template parameter, then we will compute some type function like this, common that returns common of these two types. We will define struct like this, struct common, then it will define static, it will define using type. Then it will return common of two types, T1, T2, common. Common of two types, we will implement class like this, type function like this. And to do this, we will use DECL type, DECL var function. We will implement DECL var function that returns T reference, T R-value reference like this. We will implement DECL var function and also common type function. Then we can replace it like this, common T1, T2. Then we can change GCD function like this. In this session of video, we will learn how to get a type function, how to implement type function common T. When type 2, type T1, T2 are given, we will find the common type. And also we will implement DECL var. And these concepts are very important for template method programming. And the next session, next video, we will implement enable if construct or spinner concept.
We make a blank folder, unselect or click this button that now unselect all folder, then click O5. I will say common type, create one file, common common cpp. Then we will close all the file here, include IO stream. We are creating a common type. Before we test common type, we will try to understand what common type means. Okay, say we will create a function, for example, auto int auto sum int a double p. Now let's build it. I would say max. We will build it. Return A greater than B, A else B. Okay, we want to know the type of this function. Then int main. Now we print std cout max here. Int a, I will say I, 1, double d, 2.0. A, I, B. No, we want to type function here, auto m max I d. What will be the type of m? In this case, what will be the type of m? To test that, I introduce two macros, if def funcsig is a predefined macro in Microsoft Visual C++, mx printsig, std, cout, funcsig. STD and there. Else, then this pretty function is defined in Genu C++, and if here defined is defined in Visual C++, defined in a function in GNU C++, is defined in a function in Visual C++. Okay, so we can use it template type name t void print sig t mx print sig. Like this, okay? So we, by calling this function, we can check the print sig m. Then depending on m's type, this function will be printed differently. Now let's try it. Dir cd 05 common type. G++ common cpp or show mmm common cexe. Okay, t is double. Okay, it means the type of m is double. Now let's try with Microsoft compiler CL EHSC common CPP or CEXFE CEXE. Okay, Microsoft compiler also gives double. Now if we change it, it doesn't make any difference. The value of m is still double. And if we change it to GNU compiler, it is still double. So this expression returns the common of two values. This ternary operator. Ternary operator returns is is the common type of two values. Okay, now we understand what this means, what this type means. Actually, we are not interested in value. We can simply do like this. True. We are not interested in value. We simply return. If we are interested in return type, not value, we can simply do like this. We are interested in type, not value. We can still make it the same. Still double, Microsoft compiler, still double, okay? So if we change it to short, we change the short, it will give int, integer type, so the short, it's not. We will compile it once again. Why it is double? Let's see what's the problem. Okay, we made problem here. We will change it to template. I made mistake here. Okay. It is int. Common of two type is int. Common of two type is double. Common of double and int is double. And what about signed? Common of signed and unsigned is int, signed integers. Signed and unsigned, the common of signed and unsigned is int, signed. Now let's try with GNU compiler. Okay. GNU compiler gives identical result. Now we are going to make before we make a common data type, common type function, I want to introduce one more function. Instead of we are passing values like this, what about if we pass without type? We don't have type like this. Okay. Can you do this? Now we can do like this. Okay, it works. T, int. And double. Okay, it still works. But this approach has problem. This approach has problem. Approach has a minor problem. T1 means it calls default constructor of type T1. T2 calls default constructor of T2. So we need some mechanism to test type only without actually calling, this is actually calling construct. So we need to get some type function that actually calls without, that actually returns without calling. How can you do that? We can make a function called template type name T의 R value reference DECL file. This is function. Function with no function body. Okay? No except is usually appended. Make it not to return that does not throw exception. Okay? No except means does not throw exception. So using this, we can do like this. We can do like this. Instead of this, DECL bar. DECL bar. DECL type. DECL type. Now we are making a function like this. You can make it as a common key. It returns type. And here, true. Remember what we have done. T1, T2. We have done like this, right? Instead of doing this, we will say DECL bar T1. DECL bar T2. We will change like this. Okay, so this is function. DECL bar is function. This is actually function, but it does not have function body. It does not have function body. What it means, it cares only about return type, reference return type. Also about T2's reference type. It does not care about the actual return value, but it cares return type. So we can make common T like this. Then we can use like this, but this is function. Okay? This is function header. That does not have a function body. This is also template function. I would say FUNT. FUNT. I would say like this. Save it. Now we can say common func T1. T2, it gets two arguments, and its return type, it returns type, right? It returns value, but we want to make it type. How can you make it type? DECL file. DECL type. DECL type. DECL type actually returns DECL var. DECL type expression is the type of the expression. The type of the expression, right? So it is expression. Type of the expression. It returns expression. Then we can say template type name T1, type name T2, okay, T1A, T2B, okay, then we can return A plus B, okay, the return type, this type will be the common type of A and B. Okay, say we can do like this. Sum Then if we print out the type like this, okay, let's see what's the type of M. CLS. Except the primary expression semicolon before type. Here, we actually cannot do this, right? We cannot pass T1, T2 like this. Then we can use DECL bar. DECL file, like this. Okay, DECL file. Like this. Save it. Okay, it works. It returns double, right? So if we change it to short, then the result of A and B would be M. M's type, we can also display. If we want to value, we can fix like this. It shows type. Okay. So type is int, value is 5. Yeah. Please understand how we use DECL var here. So we in common function, this is function actually, but does not have function body. Function without function body. Okay. So we have to pass argument R value argument. Then we can create, we can use this function without argument t, then it returns r value. It returns r value. But in fact this part, then DECL converts expression, this expression to type. Okay, here this part is compile time expression. This is actually not evaluated. It is evaluated only the type, return type, this type, and this function's return type, and that type is return values type, returns value type is converted to using DECL type, and this part is called immediate. This part is also immediate, also part of the immediate context. Immediate context. Okay, so please try to remember immediate context or the return type. And now we understand what DECL type means. DECL var. In standard library, DECL var is not defined like this. In standard library, DECL var is defined like this. Template type name t, struct st, add reference. Okay, here using L type T reference, using R type T R reference. This is R reference, L reference, L reference, R reference. Okay. Then DECL var, this return type is defined like this. Type name, st, add reference t, r type. Okay, this is return type. In standard C++ library, DECL var is defined like this way. The net effect is actually the same. Instead of doing this, okay, so if we build the result is actually the what's the problem? Sorry. Okay. Now run it. Okay, it runs as expected. Now using Microsoft compiler. Okay. Now we define, instead of defining how can I say common type function like this, we will change it to some other means, not like this. I will just disable it. This is one way to implement. Sorry. This is one way to implement, but we will not implement like this. I will disable it for the time being. I will disable it. Okay, we will define again here to implement common type. Type name T1, type name T2, struct. We are using struct st common type like this. You can say using type true. Okay, say T1 instead of T1, T2 instead of doing this, we are saying DECL type, DECL file T1. Okay, DECL var T2. It returns value, not type. To make it type, we see DECL type. Okay. So this is common type of to it returns common type. We can define like this: template type name T1, type name T2, using common T, type name st, common type T1, T2. Now we can change like this type. Okay, save it. Now we are defining function template, type name T1, type name T2, common T, T1, T2. Sum T1 A, T2 B. We are saying return. We can also do like this, common T, T1, T2, T, A plus B, return A plus B. Okay, so here, save it. Now let's compile and run. Okay, it's int. If we change it to double, it's double. Okay, the type of V is double. So this way we can get common type of two numbers, common type of two types. Now we want to extend it to arbitrarily. This part is important. Now we extend it to arbitrary number of as periodic template. Template type name T1, type name T2. Okay. Now we want type name types. As struct st common type here public st common type. Please note that it is recursive. It is recursive here. T1. Okay. Actually, public is not necessary, but I will just put it here. Here, type name st common type T2 types. Type. Wow. Common. Common. We use T1, T2, we use recursive function call here. Then we evaluate everything. Here, please note that this is primary. This is primary class template. This is partial specialization. Partial specialization. So we have to change it like this, T1, T2, okay? So we have to be careful about this. If you forgot this one, this is partial specialization. What is full specialization? Okay, I will explain you what is full specialization. Please remember, template argument is still used. Now, we can generalize it. Now, we can generalize it like this here. We can generalize it. Type name. Types here. Types. Okay, we now generalized it. Okay, we now generalized it. So we also generalize it. Type name. Types. Okay. Then you can say types ALGS. Okay. Here we are generalizing types. Okay. Then we can add this function. So we need to specialization here. Function specialization. And we make, as I explained it, we, okay. I will put it here, but it has bug. Okay, it has bug here. We made like this, and we have to fix it. Like this, return A plus sum B args. Okay. It has bugs, but I will explain why. I will make it simple like this. Okay, let's compile and build. Here, I will say short s equals 1, 2, 3. Okay, s. I will build here. This is Microsoft compiler. Seems to be working. Okay. 1, 2, 3. The sum is 6. It works. But it's not all. Now let's try with GNU compiler. It doesn't. GNU compiler doesn't. As I explained in the previous video, this is a periodic template. This is these two sum and sum are overloaded. It should proceed here to make it work properly, because here if it is to work, this function is to work, it has to proceed. Okay, please don't forget about this item, this thing. Now we build it. Okay, GNU compiler is happy, and also Microsoft compiler is happy. Okay, but in both cases it works. So these two functions are overloaded, and we are using common type function we defined here. I said these are partial specialization, and now I'm going to explain. Okay, I'm going to explain explicit pool specialization. But about that, I will leave it to next video. Now I copy here from our previous video. I will copy two functions here. Template GCD. Okay, I will copy this part, or I will copy from here. Here, from my third video, I will copy code, then come on here. I paste it, then we can put like this. Instead of T, common T, T1, T2. Now we are returning common of these two values. Also, we can put it here, common. And also here, types. Okay. Then everything works. Control S. Now we are calling GCD. It cannot be double actually. Let's say, okay, let's try it. Okay, GCD I D Yes. Let's try if it works. No. Double is illegal operator. Okay. Double is, in case of double, in case of double, this operator is not supported. In case of double, this operator is not supported. For the time being, I will change it long. Long, long, like this. Then we will build once again. And long, long is not supported. I will just say long. Okay. Shit, what's the problem? Okay. When it's of different type, it is not supported. When swap is not supported of different type, then how can you say? Let's introduce something like this. We will change it to A, B, like this. Then we are making of the same type. Come on. T, T1, T2, A equals AA. Okay. Come on. T, T1, T2, B equals BB. Like this. Okay. Then it should work. Then it should work. Let's see. Okay. Okay, it works. But let's see. Okay, let's make it more fun. 2, 5, 7. Okay, we saved it. Now build it. Yes. Works. Okay. The type is, the common type is long and it all works. Okay. So this way we converted GCD to accept arbitrary different type. But there is something missing. So how we are going to test if it is integer type, or signed type, or unsigned type. Okay, now let's build signed type and unsigned type. Just one thing more. We are defining template, type name, t, struct, st, signed type, static constant bool value false. This is primary class template. Okay. Now we use explicit specialization. I said explicit specialization. I'll say is signed type. Is signed type. Okay. To use partial specialization, we make something like this. Here, int short. Short is signed type. This is full specialization. Specialization, why is called explicit specialization? Specialization. This is called full specialization or This is called full specialization or explicit specialization. Please compare what is full specialization and here partial specialization. In case of partial specialization, we still use template argument like this. But in case of full specialization, we are actually provide a type argument like this. Okay. Now we create another one, signed type. There is another signed type, for example, integer, and also another signed. Here long, and another long has signed type. Here long. Okay, sorry, I have to change. This is false, and this should be true, and this also should be true. And this also should be true. And this also should be true. Okay. Now we are creating a variable template. Template type name t. Say constant expr bool is signed, signed is signed. I will say st is signed type t value. Okay, now we will use now we will use this variable template like this. I will disable it. Disable. Okay. I will have here unsigned UNSID. Unsigned. UNSIGNED. Unsigned U. I would name it like 11. I will like this. Say if is signed I then std cout I is signed. I say is signed, else std cout is not signed. Okay, control S. Now I build it and test it. Is signed is a variable template called template argument list here. 156 is signed. What's wrong? Is signed. This is not function. We have to do this. For example, int. I will first test this. Okay, signed. Okay, int is signed. Unsigned. See, not signed. Okay. Then how we are going to pass type of I? Type of I. We can get type of I like this. Type of I, DECL type. See, DECL type returns like this. See, signed. I is signed. If we say you, okay, not signed. So it works. Now let's try with the GNU compiler. See, not signed. So this is explicit specialization, or is called full specialization. We are making one more for signed integer. Now copy this. I copied up to this point. I pasted it. Now say is unsigned. Is unsigned. Is unsigned. False. Now here, unsigned short. Unsigned short true. Unsigned int true. Unsigned wrong. Long. Unsigned long long. Sorry, I have to change the type name. Unsigned type, unsigned type, unsigned type, unsigned type, unsigned type. Here, you would say is unsigned. Unsigned, okay? So we can test is unsigned. Okay, not signed. Sorry, there is some problems. Now let's test what's the problem. Is unsigned, is unsigned. Unsigned. Oh my goodness, it's confusing. We change in the wrong place. Is signed. Is signed, is signed, is signed, is signed. Here is signed. Now is unsigned. We have to change it to is unsigned. 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 Okay. Now double check. Ctrl KS. We have to say is unsigned. Is not unsigned. Okay? Because we used unsigned. Unsigned here. Yes, is unsigned. Now try it. Is unsigned. U is unsigned. Now try with I. I is not signed. Not signed means not unsigned means signed, right? Now we combine these two like this. Template. Type name T, constant expr, bool is integral, we can define like this. Then is signed T or is unsigned T. Okay. If it is integer type, if the type T is integer, it should be either signed or unsigned. We intentionally omitted the boolean value and the character, signed character, unsigned character, we removed, we have not included in this categorization. Then we can test something like this. I will disable it. To test numbers that we want to combine as integer type, we can do like this. If is integral here, DECL type I, you can say I is std cout, I is integral of integer. Else std cout is not of integer. Save and run. Shit. I think I made here. We need a semicolon. Okay. Is of integer. Now we define double, for example. Okay. If we define s as double, is not of integer. So this way we can define, we can tell if some value is integer or not integer. Something like this. So these are called function type, type function. So I think I laid out most fundamental things about type functions, and then in next video we will combine all these things in a single place, and we will introduce type traits, header file type traits in my next video. Thank you for watching.